car after about a 500-mile drive to be here, just to see Matt LaRanger without his blonde mohawk. The next award is my JV MVP. And that is, again, this young man is a leader. He's a guy you can count on during practice to be focused, working hard, on and off the field. He knows who I'm talking to and who I'm talking about. That's going to be Jack Murray. It was hard for me to pick out five players and give them an award out of the squad we had. This young man showed up at practice every day. He worked hard. Every day that I remember after practice, he came up to me and gave me a handshake and told me thank you. And I'm not particularly sure why. But my coach's award is going to Colton Hughes. Hey, again, the group of boys I had to coach this year, I had DJ, who was very hardworking. I had Matt Sheedy, who played anywhere I asked him to and did pretty darn well at it. I had Kevin Murphy. Watch out, wink, Kevin. That's going to get you in trouble in a few years. Let's see. I had Nick Chu. Again, Nick could easily have been up for one of these awards. Nick played anywhere I asked him to, and he gave 100% as well. Alec Weeman, one of the hardest natural tacklers I've ever seen. Lucas. Jeff Galata. Scored his first high school goal, came in as a goalie, and ended up playing out in the field. I had I had Robbie Bukowski. I had some upperclassmen leaders. I'll get to you, Tony, bear with me. I had Aiden Lerner, Clint Rossi, Pat Bingle, back with me again. Tony Searcy, Josh Leifer came down to play with us. Am I forgetting anybody else? Mr. Mazzola, who I don't see here. Basketball players, right? Well, I'm looking forward to seeing you guys contribute to varsity next year, and looking forward to working with another great group of players, and we'll see you boys next season. I have a couple of words I'd like to say about the varsity boys program real quickly, and I'm starting from the top here. About 4 years ago, when I was in my late 40s, I was diving for a ball up at Camp Manitou, and I saw all I can say is a leprechaun, about 5'6", come kicking the ball into my stomach. I did make the save, by the way, just in case. That's Coach Eric Green, and I'm going to give him a big round of applause right now. Over the last few years, I feel happy that I've been able to count him among my friends. And watching what he's done with this program since I've been involved with it has been nothing short of amazing at times. His dedication, his manner with the boys, his passion, his intensity. I think this is your second year as the TBL Coach of the Year. You've got the Eastern Mass Coach of the Year. You've got a nice tie on. We knew going into the season that we were losing Nick Gale, who had been a big part of the program and who I have a lot of respect for and affection for as well. He knows that. And Coach Green just continues to step up to the plate. And the things these boys accomplished under his direction, I think, are nothing short of amazing. In my book, I'm very proud of all you players, all you players. And Coach Green, I'm very proud of you as well, and feel fortunate to be part of your program. I knew during the playoffs, there was a moment we hit when I just looked over at Eric, and he looked haggard, he looked stressed out, he looked fatigued, it looked like he had aged a couple of days, or I'm sorry, a couple of decades in a matter of days, and I got very concerned. And then I realized that was actually me in the Sun Chronicle picture and not him. Hope you're all reading. Make sure you get your bartenders and waitresses. Now, we had a laugh about that. It was quite embarrassing for me because, you know, I feel like you're getting the credit you deserve. And you know, one of the things that was great, we were actually seeing coaches that we had defeated at the games rooting for us. And that doesn't often happen. And, you know, I know that all your opponents have a lot of respect for you. That says a lot about you. And I know that all your friends have a lot of respect for you as well. Let's see, I'm almost done here. Now I'm going to speak to the boys real quick. These varsity boys, all 25 of them who made the roster for the playoffs. You know, we probably had 14 players, Coach, maybe 15 players who played minutes in that playoff run in particular. But I want to make sure that all of you guys who didn't play minutes but were part of that roster understand how important you were to the run these boys had. You had guys like Matt Morrell, who came out and decided he was going to be just a keeper this year and pushed really hard to push Ryan Blakely and help continue to give him a challenge. You had all the boys working hard in scrimmages to help provide you players who were on the field with the best practices you could get in your preparation. And I think all 25 of you should be very proud of what you were able to accomplish. I'm very proud of your coach for helping get you there. I'd like for you to give yourselves a hand, boys. A couple of the characteristics that I saw out of you, and of course this was all much clearer while I was driving at 65 and 70 miles an hour to get here. When I sat down to try to write it down, some of it disappeared. But your discipline, the way you approached your season, your work from summer league camp on, your determination when you went down goals, you kept working, you know, the way you remained calm in the face of adversity. I think if you boys are able to take those traits out into your daily lives, that you're going to accomplish big things for yourself, for your school, for your community as you go forward in life. And I'm really looking forward to see where you guys end up. I'm very proud of all of you. I was looking for something to say for you on the way back, and ironically, I found it on the back of a tractor trailer. And I guess what I would say to the senior boys, some of you I may not see again, I hope I do, but what I would suggest to you would be these three phrases: that you be kind, that you be careful, and that you be yourselves. And I'm looking forward to hearing about you doing big things with your lives, and I'm proud to share this last month or so with you. Thank you.